Welcome everybody to day three of the Pathway of Hope sessions. We've had a great start to the week. We're just going to open with a word of prayer. Dear Lord, thank you for bringing us together virtually. Please help us have a great lesson today and help us to learn something insightful from it. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Nothing to say, they just lost their dearest friend. All that he said, now he was dead, so this was the way it would end. The dreams they had dreamed were not what they seemed. Now he was dead and gone. The garden, the jail, the hammer, the nail. How could a night be so long? The angel, the star, the kings from afar, the wedding, the water, the wine. Now it was done, they'd taken her son, wasted at his time. She knew it was was true. She'd watched him die too. She heard them call him just the man. But deep in her heart, she knew from the start, somehow her son would live again. Then came the morning, night turned into day. The stone was rolled away. Hope rose with the dawn. Then came the morning. Shadows vanished before the sun. Death had lost and life had won.
To do in a little while we're going, and the grace of God will our daily strength renew. In a little while we're going, in a little while, in a little while, we shall cross the billows, we shall meet. When the stormy winds are past, in a little while we're going home. Smooth the path for some weary wayworn feet, in a little while we're going home. And may loving spread it round influence sweet, in a little while we're going home. In a little while, in a little while, we shall cross the billows fall. We shall meet at last when the stormy winds are. In a little while.
There's a rest beyond, there's relief from every care. In a little while we're going home. And no tears shall fall in that city bright and fair. In a little while we're going home. In a little while, in a little while, we shall cross the billows foam. We shall meet at last when the stormy winds are past. In a little while we're going home.
Amen. Thank you to all those who sang for us. Now to those who did not sing, I would want you to share with us how this pandemic has affected you from the time we started in March, and how you've managed to cope with it, and what keeps you going, if anything, if there's a verse that keeps you going that you want to share with us, or a testimony of something that might have happened during this pandemic and how you managed to go through and what helped you to get by. So in that manner, if you can take turns to share your experiences. We're going to start with, we do it alphabetically, from the top to bottom, from the bottom up. I'm going to go with Ayanda. Ayanda, if you can share what it was like when we were told that this is the last week, you can't go to church anymore, and how it's been for you, what has kept you going.
It's just a bit, can you rephrase the question?
I was saying, how did it make you feel knowing that we had to go on virtual church since March? How did it make you feel, and how have you managed to cope till now? And if there's any verse that you want to share with us, what keeps you going? Seeing we can't see each other still, what gives you hope? Ayanda.
Hello? Oh, what keeps me going is AY.
Is that all? I mean, how did it make you feel that we're going virtual from March?
Oh, obviously a bit sad, because it meant that I can't really go to church anymore. And I feel like going to church made me feel closer to God, because it meant that I was in his presence. But it's a bit different, because now I'm at home in my room and I wake up really late. So.
It's been a challenge. Okay, thank you. Let's hear from Emmanuel. Emmanuel.
Give a second. It's been a bit tough knowing that I can't go back to church, because with church, I like being in the Lord's house, but now I'm just stuck at home on the lives and stuff. So anything which keeps me going is coming to see people on Blue Jeans, and knowing that everyone's fine and whatnot. So, yeah.
Okay, thank you. Let's hear from Edith, all the way from Sheffield.
Well, at first it was like really difficult it's more difficult now than it was before, because I was at home then. So church was like, oh, mum will come wake you up, you get ready, you come downstairs. But now it's like I'm on my own, and I have to do it all by myself. There's no one there to like kind of police me into doing it. So it's like, I really have to do this by myself, and then go from like churches to churches. So seeing people weekly and then having calls with them, it is really nice. And that's kind of what's keeping me going. But other than that, yeah.
Any volunteer without me picking anyone up? Anyone who's ready to share?
I think everyone's pretty much got the same kind of answer. Like, you don't really have the opportunity to see your friends every week, to see people that you love every week. For some people, they're not really living with their parents right now, so it's a bit tougher for like students, because I've literally just came here 3 weeks ago. So now I'm starting to feel the effects of not meeting anyone for church, because now when you're on your own, it's kind of exemplified. It's like exaggerated how bad it is. But I feel like Yeah, it's pretty much been the same for everyone, but especially for Lange and Edith. I just want to know like how they're coping with being first years and everything's virtual. So it's a bit weird because when I came to uni, I got to see the church. I got to like join different societies at uni and stuff. So yeah, how are you guys coping with that aspect of everything?
At the start, I had quite mixed emotions because obviously I'm still in school, I'm still in secondary school, and I've got exams as well. So the fact that we were closing and we had to do school online, which were not really regular as well, and the fact that I had to stay at home in the house with my parents 24/7, and with everything else that was going on as well, it was quite overwhelming. But then at the same time, I didn't have to wake up every morning, make my way to school, and basically get out the house for a bit. It was almost like a second holiday, summer holiday. So it wasn't as bad as I was expecting, but obviously as time went on, I could really feel that this lockdown was affecting me mentally and physically.
If you were to give someone like a message of hope, any scripture that keeps you going or a song that keeps you going on your own, what would it be? Thelma, Serena, you're very quiet and sway. Welcome, Lance.
So, so you know, I'm just gonna be real here and just say, you know, it's easy to start saying you don't like people. Like, you know, when you have the opportunity and people are around, it's so easy to just go, I don't like people. But it's when you're put into lockdown and you can't see those people that you actually realize, rah, I like those people, to be honest, and I wish they were here. Because listen, when the lockdown started, I was like, oh, okay, that's fine. And then one day I found myself barbecuing by myself. Do you know how sad that is? I mean, barbecuing by yourself, that's got to be sad. But I couldn't go and see my family. I couldn't invite a friend. It was so sad. But then one thing for me has remained the same. Virtual church, listen to me. This has been a blessing in my life, like a blessing. Because for one, on a Saturday, I don't want to wake up early. I do that all through the week. So for me to have virtual church, I don't have to wake up that early. I can, you know, just get up, wash my face, you know, do a quick rub-a-dub-dub, and then I'm ready. So, and I feel like I have ministered more now than I used to when we used to go to church. Now, it's just so easy. You just send a link. Just send a link and be like, yo, if you've got time, come and check out what we talk about. I've had my cousins come through. I've had like friends come through. And I feel like this is so perfect. If I could take just one thing, I would keep the virtual church. And ongoing, so many songs have kept me going because, you know, I'm more of a song person than I'm a prayer person. Okay, this sounds wrong. Can we do a take two? Mm-hmm. But I'm just saying, it's so easy to just burst out in song than it is to like kneel down and pray. So I find that music has been very helpful.
So which song? Each one.
Right. So I have a lot. I have found myself singing All the Way My Savior Leads Me. And what's the song? Come Thou Fount of Every Blessing. Yeah, those are the top two songs that I've sang the most during this lockdown.
Thank you. Let's hear from Kelvin Sway.
Well, I can honestly say I've not really enjoyed the lockdown since it started. Like, even though I'm closed off, shy and whatnot, I really do enjoy people's company, and not having that has, well, how can I say it, had a mental drain on me. Like, it's some points I've been really low, like, it's just been unbearable. And then, what, for me to get myself back up, I would have to tell myself, well, actually, not tell myself, I'd actually go into prayer with God, and then just talk to him for 10 minutes or so, and then get back to what I was doing. And then other things would just be either reading a scripture, but that was like the first 3-4 months of lockdown and whatnot. I mean, that's all I've been doing, just to try keep sane, if you know what I mean.
You know, the news of young people feeling depressed and feeling quite suicidal during this lockdown, how does that make you feel? How do you feel like you're in a different space to them? I mean, what keeps you going? What keeps you, I mean, sane, as in maybe having mental health breakdown? What keeps you going? Clarence, got anything to share? And how does that make you feel?
Well, I'm typically impartial to a lot of things. I just do what I have to do for the most part. You know, just obligations to whoever is around, you know, like the family and whatever. So that's the main thing that I focus on. I try not to make it about me as much and just do whatever has to be done. But of course it does get hard. And, you know, like, I've not seen a huge amount of people since March. Since that 1 week in March, I've not seen so many people from Leicester. I think the only people I saw was like Sway and Sibs and them, literally within the last 2 weeks before I went to uni. They're the only people I saw of my friends since March, and I'm pretty sure I won't see many of them soon regardless. But I don't, it's not really much of an option for me to give up or anything like that. That's not in my range, giving up or stopping. That's not something I can do, so I just have to keep moving. I make it about me as little as possible, and I do it for my siblings and whoever else depends on me, that sort of thing. And that's how I get by.
That's interesting. That's really interesting. How about you, Langa? Langa?
Can you just repeat the question, please?
I was just saying, just hearing the news and reading on the papers about young people being mostly challenged, and that some of our own, like from our church, have stopped, they've given up, they don't go to church anymore since this virtual thing started. I mean, how would you say you are reacting differently to that? What keeps you going?
What would keep me going is just talking to people, not keeping things to yourself. Sometimes it is hard to speak to people, but if you find that one person that you can just speak to about anything, it can help you get through, even for just a day. Like if I'm having a rough day, I know there's one person I can speak to and that will help me through. Also just keeping occupied with things, so like taking up a hobby or reading a book, or even coming onto like this platform, Blue Jeans, it takes my mind off what's going on in my mind for even just like an hour.
Yeah, Serena, let's hear you before we go on to the next point.
Okay, so basically, I feel like the whole corona, I feel like I've been okay because I still had to go to work and I work with children. So when I work with children, it gives me that feeling of, you know what, I still need to keep going and I still need to stay positive. And also, I agree with Thelma about how I think we should keep this virtual Blue Jeans church, online church, because I feel like the youth have been more active and we've just been doing more things. And especially me, like, I never thought I would actually lead out, like, in something. Like Daniel 6, and I think that really, like, showed me that I can do much more in the church. So I think just everyone should just have a positive, think positive and not negative, and just tell yourself, you know what, I can pull through this. And the one song that stayed with me was Never Would Have Made It Without You by Marvin Sapp. So, yeah.
I thought you were going to sing. I thought you were going to sing for us there. Okay. While we think about the next point will be, what was the highest from March until now? What was your highest point, like on this virtual church or being away from church? What was your highest moment or the lowest moment? Just two. Before you get to that, I just want to comment a comment from the adults amongst us, Sister Anel and Brother Ade. We've been together since the beginning. How has this whole virtual thing treated you? Like, I know Elder Ade, on top of being an elder, you sometimes moderate and making sure people are in the right groups and everything. We'll start with Sister Anel, then Elder Ade. Unless there is someone, young person, that I've missed out. Bradley, I've missed you out. Let's hear from Bradley. Bradley,
what was the question again?
I was saying, how have you been managing since the lockdown, since we've been using the virtual church? What have been your challenges and what has kept you going? If there's any song or verse that you want to share, whatever has kept you going, if you can share with us.
Oh, what's kept me going is the church services online. I listened to a few gospel songs on my phone, but that's about it. Mm. Yeah.
Yeah, you're saying? Okay, Auntie Anel, and then Elder Ade, Elder Nsingo as well, the adults that we've been working with.
Coming on to the virtual church has been a relief. I was unfortunate at some point that I was I tested positive for the virus, and I spent a few weeks unwell, but I could manage. I love working with the youth, even if I couldn't manage the whole church program. I could manage to just log in and meet with the youth, have a few laughs, because they are such brilliant, a brilliant group of individuals, different, but they inspire me in many ways. So I could manage to just lie down and tune into the youth program, even their AY, even if I didn't manage to get on to the sermons for the day. And this has kept me going. And a verse that has carried me most of my life would be Psalms 27 verse 1. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the strength of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? It goes on, the whole chapter is quite inspirational, but I'm saying, during dark days like these, the Lord is still our light, and he is still working amongst us, and he's still working amongst young people. So if there is anything as well, I would take, even if the lockdown ends, I would favor this virtual meeting, because we have done so much. We have spoken so much, we've inspired each other and kept each other going through the lockdown.
Elder.
For me, since I think I was, it before lockdown, I actually even go to church, not mostly for myself. I go because I would, if I might be able to bless somebody that day. So that's what drives me. That's what made me go to church. And now lockdown, virtual church, it's the mission is still the same. The mission is still the same. I'm present here. Somebody might benefit from me. And, you know, coupled with other things that I do. But the highlight during this lockdown for me is the real talks that we've had. You know, it's been very, very, insightful to see the youth talk the way they talk. It's a different shift entirely from the people I used to know. And the people I see now on blue jeans. So I'm still hoping that when this is over, we would keep the personality, we will keep the real talks, you know, even in the physical church. And then, you know, I know some people are still hoping we'll have some form of virtual church, and I hope also that we'll probably have that on the side as well and continue, you know, have a way to balance it up. But it's been a wonderful experience to see people, you know, come out and, you know, it's like Serena was saying, lead out and all the other young people, the way we talk, the way they share, you know, it's been lovely. So for me, I'm upbeat and positive and hopeful that at least good things are coming out of whatever is even happening right now.
Okay, is Eldon Zimwa there?
No, it's okay. You can move on.
Okay, yeah, I was saying if we can look at the lowest moments and the highlights of the lockdown from March till now, is there anything that you want to point out as one of your highest moments or one of your lowest moments during lockdown? And if it was your lowest, how did you come out of that?
I think my highest moments of this lockdown is being able to get become closer with my family, of course. This lockdown really helped to soothe and to mend our relationship as a family, of course. We were able to spend more time with each other, talk more with each other, be able to understand each other more. And by the end of the lockdown, we were able to become more of a family. I'm not sure if I'm saying this right, but as a result of this lockdown, we were able to be able to come closer to one another and to be able to pick out whether we are upset or whether our mood changes, and we'll be able to help each other. So that benefited us individually, emotionally and mentally as well. So that was one, you know, high of my lockdown.
Okay. Anyone else? The highlight of the lockdown? So we all had the lowest. We don't have any highlights. What really you could look back and think, oh wow, that was the best time during even if we're in lockdown, that was good. Anyone with the highlight?
I have a highlight. So we did this mother and daughter situation. That was one of my highlights. Even though it was virtual, it was one of my highlights. We did some sessions on dating, alcohol. Listen to me, AYS was my highlight. Like, I look forward to every Saturday so we can, like, I look forward to fighting with Anesu here. Like, it's not, we're not fighting, but like, it's an amazing thing, you know, because you've got something that's occupying your mind at that time. You don't think about, you know, whether you're out of the job, whether you're still in uni, you were supposed to finish, but you haven't finished yet. You don't think about that. It's when you come to AYS and, you know, it's just like, it's like family on a camera. Yeah, that's amazing. It's like we're playing Google. It's like we're on Google Box and it's amazing, but we can communicate with each other.
Highlight, Nanti. What was your highlight?
I agree with Dharma. It was definitely the real talks that we had about dating. Alcohol was an interesting one. There was a lot of memeable moments in the alcohol discussion. So yeah, I would agree with Dama. Our AYSs are, yeah, they're lit. Like, yeah. So.
Yes, Kelvin?
I just want to say AYS was literally a blessing in disguise. Like, I mean, I know there's some points during the lockdown where I would not come to church for weeks and whatnot, but I would literally make time to go to AYS because, I don't know, it feels like family just getting together and catching jokes. And yeah, I'd say that's probably one of my highlights.
Anyone else? Serena, you're too serious there. What would you say was your highlight? I can't hear you.
It's because I was talking to my mom.
Okay.
So my highlight, well, my mom says my highlight is growing spiritually. And then my highlight to me, I feel like I've been able to come out my shell and just like be real and have like deep conversations on AYS. And just being happy, really. I just feel like I've been more happy and more laughable. I've been laughing a lot. So yeah.
Okay. Can I just say something about the lockdown for me? Because I remember when we were told that we weren't going to go to church, I remember Elder Ade pulling up in a very nice car. I think it was the last supper that we were supposed to start, and we're all admiring Elder Ade's car, but he was showing symptoms or something, so we couldn't even talk to him. It was just from a distance. And then the week after that, there was no church, and then I was just chilling, enjoying myself, like, oh wow, I needed a break. And then out of the blue, Elder Ade says, oh, we need to be doing something with the youth. Like, what can I do with you? I remember I was really apprehensive about it, and I didn't understand what I was supposed to do. I was really, really not for the idea. I tried everything to say, no, we can't, no. But, you know, once it started, it's been a blessing to see you guys, especially when I had to give you all a chapter to lead out in Daniel, which you all executed very well. That was the highlight for me. And I was like, oh wow, they can do that. What else can I do? I kept pushing. And for me, it's each time I push you, you always rise to the occasion. Somehow this virtual church also fought for it, because I have seen the best come out of you. The trying period of us not being in church has brought out the best in you, really. That's the highlight for me. I don't know if anyone else has got something else. The dip was the time when my son was ill, because he got ill during lockdown. Us taking him to hospital and being told you have to leave him now. Just leaving him there at the Royal and then waiting and hoping for the best. And then he has an operation, a major operation. We can't be there for him. I remember one time when I had to take some gadgets for him, his phone and his charger. Somehow, I wasn't allowed to be on the ward, but because they were a bit sloppy, you know me, I take my chances, I just pushed myself in, I was on the ward. And then when they turned around, they saw me, I was just waving at my son, and then the nurse said to tape him, there is your mom. That was the highlight for me, just to see him there in the recovery ward. But I want to thank God that our lawyer's time then has turned into a blessing, because he is at home, he's recovering. And we thank God for your prayers. You know, one thing that has come out of this virtual is that we are there for one another. Even if we don't see each other, if someone puts a prayer request, we are so quick to respond. sometimes I think when we are in church, we are too relaxed because we always take it for granted. I'm going to see them anyway next week. But the virtual has brought us closer. I don't know if anyone has got something else to add from the adults. Nanti?
I just wanted to add another highlight, which was one of the Wednesday prayer meetings. And it was the Wednesday prayer meeting that I was told to lead out. It really was a blessing in disguise because I think after then, that's when I thought I really want to join these Wednesday prayer meetings because the unity there and the love that you can feel from everyone. Everyone wants to hear what people are going through. There's like updates of how your week has been. That really meant a lot to me because it was kind of a way to like, it was a come to Jesus moment. So it really meant a lot to me because it was really a high in my spiritual journey, especially, and also mentally because I was going through a lot that week. So yeah, I just wanted to add that.
Just to add to what Nanti is saying, behind the scenes, there was a big struggle. When I said, Nanti, do you mind leading out on Wednesday? She was going through something and she was not really, it was a wrestle with her emotion and the spirituality and everything. But when she did take on the challenge, it was indeed a blessing. And, you know, everyone was like, oh, thank you, Nanti. This is just what we needed, you know? It's really amazing. Once you just put yourself out there, I remember the first time I saw Thelma lead out Sabbath morning prayer. That was amazing. So I don't know if any adult wants to add on to what I've said. It's really been an amazing moment sharing the gospel with you guys virtually. Shall we call it a day? Unless someone else wants to say something, because I know we've got 3 minutes before we have our next session. Do you have any closing remarks or any closing comments? If you were to give someone a message of hope in one sentence, what would it be? If we just go around and just give a message of hope for this lockdown period, what would it be? It could be a verse, it could be just one stanza of a song, whatever you can, to give someone who is really about to give up on this whole virtual thing, what would you say to them? Emmanuel, one sentence, message of hope. You can start, Thelma.
I would say roses will bloom again. Everything has a reason and a season, so don't worry about whatever's going on right now. Roses will bloom again.
Mm-hmm.
There's a verse that I like from Psalms 31, it's verse 24, and it says, "Be of good courage, and he shall strengthen your heart, and ye shall hope. Ye shall have that hope in the Lord." What it says is basically just don't be afraid to do whatever you are wanting to do. And once you do, when you take action in what you're supposed to be doing, the Lord will provide you with the strength and the courage, because he is the provider of all strength and courage.
Amen.
Right, me and Emmanuel, what's that?
God. What's the courage, Rick?
Come on, Ayana.
He wanted to say that tough times never last, only tough people last.
Only Emmanuel, man.
What did he say? Tough times what would bring
tough on times never last, but tough people last. I'll send you later.
Anyway, any message of hope? Let's hear from someone else.
Yeah, I got one. I mean, all I just want to say is keep loving your heart. And yeah, that's all.
Next. As quick as can be, already behind time. Any other message, then we can stop the recording. Clarence, want to say something? We can't hear you.
Hear me now.
Yeah.
I say Isaiah 54:17. No weapon formed against thee shall prosper, and every tongue which rises against you in judgment you shall condemn. This is the heritage of the servants of their Lord, of the Lord, and the righteousness is from me, thus saith the Lord.
Amen. Amen. Any other message of hope?
I never would have made it without you. I would have lost it all. But now I see how you were there for me.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Sister. Yes, yeah. Nanti.
I guess Joshua 1, verses 9. Have I not commanded you, be strong and courageous. Do not be afraid. Do not be discouraged. For the Lord your God goes with you wherever you go.
Amen. 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 Any other message of hope?
He who began a good work in you will carry it to completion.
Amen. Amen. Any other?
All things work together for the good of those that love God and are called according to his purpose.
So, amen. 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 Right. Want to leave anyone out? Edith, do you want to say something?
Yeah, I think don't leave things in. Talk to people. Voice whatever troubles you have and find someone to talk to. If you don't have someone to talk to, then, like, you know, talk to God and stuff. But don't let things harbour in your heart. Keep speaking to people and let those emotions out.
Thank you. Thank you. I just wanted to say, there's nothing.
I just want to add one more thing. The fact that each and every one of us have come through so many things, even from hearing everyone's testimonies, we should really be giving ourselves a pat on the back at this point. Because it's not easy to get through 2020, a pandemic, having to stay away from it, like, honestly. So I feel like sometimes we need to give ourselves credit because, honestly, we wouldn't have gotten here. The fact that we're here, we're well, we're all here on this Blue Jeans right now is just a blessing and a testimony in itself.
Mm. Yes, Auntie Anil, you can't keep quiet.
The Lord has brought us this far. He will carry us through this pandemic. He is still God, unchanging, and he will always be there for us. Just call on him.
If I could sing, I would be singing, I just can't give up now. I don't know how it goes, but the Lord has brought us this far. He is going to be with us throughout Ebenezer. He's brought us this far. He's going to see us through. I just want to thank you all. And my message to you this evening is, let's look out for one another. If we join in on Blue Jeans and you don't see Nanti, get on Nanti's phone. Where are you? We've started. Let's be each other's keeper. Let's look out for one another. Thank you very much for joining today. I hope you all have a good week. And stay safe and stay well. Let God's blessings continue to fall on you. Let his protection be on you. Be there for one another. Amen.
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 Amen. Amen.
In my head that say I'm not enough. Every single lie that tells me I will never measure up.
at your feet. You have every failure, God, you have every victory. You will say I am loved when I can't feel a thing. You will say I am strong when I think I am weak. And you will say I am helped when I have fallen short. And when I don't belong, oh, you say I am yours. And I believe, yes, I believe what you say of me.
It's time for the closing prayer. Please bow your heads. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you for bringing us here today. I pray that we learn something valuable from this lesson, and I pray that we have a good rest of the week. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Touch me, O God, and know my heart today.